going to see about perspective projection, where perspective projection is the lines convergence in a point behind the view plane, where in perspective we are going to see 1 point, 2 point, as well as 3 point. And the best example I can say with respect to difference between your parallel and perspective projection, in parallel projection we are going to see the direction of projection, whereas in perspective projection we are going to see center of projection. Okay, in parallel projection we are going to view what is the direction of projection, from which viewpoint you are going to view the viewing plane. So that's why the direction of the viewing plane, whereas in perspective projection center of projection you are going to discuss. Okay, so that's why the projection lines converge in a point behind viewing plane. Okay, so does not preserve any relative size, but it looks more realistic compared to parallel projection. Perspective projection looks more realistic. Okay, so what are the parameters involved in perspective projections? As simple, your eye, view direction, view of vector value, normal to image plane. Suppose if you consider the viewing direction value all 0, 0, 0, okay, that is your camera eye, and view direction and normal to the image plane is coincident with the z axis, and view vector is coincident with y axis. Why? Because when you are going to calculate normal to the image plane, you will take the view up vector with respect to y axis. Okay, so here you have to take the x point, y point value with respect to your viewing direction x comma y comma z, and the distance you can take with respect to your z if you are viewing through the z viewpoint. Okay, and in perspective projection a closer objects look larger, where all meets at one point that we used to call the projection reference is one point. Okay, where on the viewing plane your value projection value with respect to x comma y comma z, and on the viewing plane your x projection point, y projection point, and through which is the viewpoint, z is the viewpoint, then you have to calculate what is the perspective projection value with respect to x perspective, y perspective, and z perspective. Okay, and with respect to this projection point you are going to calculate the perspective projections, right, where you can see the 3D view, top view, as well as side view. And here on your x y plane, okay, z is the viewpoint, and you will take the value with respect to your x point, y point, and z viewpoint. Okay, so in this case your z value is going to be the distance from this z view to the viewing plane, right? So when you consider the distance, z point is nothing but the distance, and where you can take the value x, by z equal to x point by distance, right? And similarly, you can take y by z equal to y by distance. So final conversion you can write with respect to x point equal to x divided by z by d. Similarly for y point, y divided by z by d. Okay, and where your z point is your the viewing vector distance on view plane. Suppose if you consider here xy plane, the distance from this z viewpoint to particular x point and y point, take the value with the distance d. Okay, so a point in space x comma y comma z is projected along a projector into the point x point, y point and z point. Okay, so all the projector passes through the origin because the projection plane is perpendicular to z axis. If it is perpendicular to z axis, then your z value is going to be d, and if it is a left handed operation, it is going to be minus d. So when you are going to put into the parametric representation of your point on the line connecting x comma y comma z with perspective projection, x perspective as well as y perspective as well as z perspective, you can write x dash equal to x minus perspective projection into the view volume as well as similarly y and z. Okay, so the viewing plane value you can write z viewing point minus z divided by z perspective projection minus z. Okay, so substitute this above said equations where x by z equal to x point divided by t and y point equal to y divided by z by d. Substitute in this, you will get the value x point as well as y point. The perspective projections, we have three different types: 1 point perspective projection, 2 point perspective projection, 3 point perspective projection. 1 point is parallel perspective, 2 point is angular perspective, 3 point is bird view. When you are going to see from the sky low to the bottom, okay, and when you are going to view from one of the viewing plane, viewing direction, and considering the view plane where your value starting point with the viewing direction point with respect to x comma y comma z on your viewing plane, you are going to view from z direction. So the z viewpoint and with respect to your x point and y point, you are going to calculate the perspective view. What is the problem when you substitute the view plane values? The problem with the above representation, parametric representation, is that your z appears in denominator. So what will happen when you do the matrix multiplication representation of x as well as y on view plane as a function of z is not straightforward. Okay, so then what will happen, your z value is set point specific, hence the division will be computation killer. So we can make it the solution, but it is little expensive, that I will tell you. A different representation is in order, so transformation can be concatenated. Concatenated, which means with respect to two different view of with respect to your viewing plane. Okay, and to
get rid of that particular z in denominator. So we define the parameter h when you are going to add in a new homogeneous coordinates, replace the space value where h equal to z perspective minus z. Okay, and you can substitute in that particular equation so that x point x h divided by h as well as y point equal to y h divided by h, and that you can substitute and you will get x h is equal to x into z perspective minus z viewpoint plus your z x perspective into z viewpoint minus z, so which will yield these two equation after you add h equal to z perspective minus z. Okay, and given the initial point from the viewing direction p equal to x comma y comma z comma 1, and when you are going to add new homogeneous coordinate value x h comma y h comma z h comma h where you specified h equal to z viewpoint minus z, okay, sorry, z perspective minus z, okay, and where you will write in transformation matrix and m perspective view into p, okay, in your matrix representation z perspective minus z viewpoint with respective x as well as with respective y, and you are going to scale whether it is near or far with respective z, okay, and where z is equal to, you are going to scale the particular z plus the distance, okay, distance what d with respective z, okay, and z h is using the scaling factor with respective z and the translation t, so s z and this t z can be set arbitrarily, so we will set those to satisfy desired normalization, where you can write the normalization with respect to what your set three different points, up vector, viewing direction and viewing plane values, okay, and transformed z coordinate is very useful for deciding on hidden parts of the scene when you are going to view. In one view is the very basic, one point view is the very basic in perspective projection, and two point view often we use, but three point rarely we use, okay, so notice that drawing the perspective point requires division by h, where your h depends on z coordinate, hence every point must be divided by a different number, which is very expensive, okay, so here one of the factor what we have to discuss with respect to perspective projection is vanishing points. When suppose if you are going to take example of your what you call the train route, okay, when you are going to view closer, it appears closer, bigger. When you view towards along, where it will vanish, so one vanishing point between two parallel lines, so vanishing point occurs when the viewing plane intersects with the axis of viewing coordinate system. When you take a cube, the principal axis for a cube with respect to your coordinate of x comma y comma z, which means parallel to z lines of x z plane and parallel lines to z in y z plane will vanish. So vanishing point on viewing plane correspondent to infinity in the world. Suppose if you are going to view two parallel lines, if you take the train track, okay, and you are going to view closer, you may look larger, but in far, okay, at one point it vanish. So the vanishing point between two parallel lines. Here you consider with respect to any two different plane, and your vanishing point. So viewing plane is parallel to y axis, intersecting both x axis and z axis. Okay, so you can see here x axis vanishing point and z axis vanishing point. Okay, and vanishing point of all three axes occur when viewing plane intersect all three axes. So based on this only, as I said, like 1 point, 2 point, 3 point. 1 point is the parallel perspective, 2 point is angular perspective, and your 3 point is your bird eye view. Okay, so perspective projection as a view volume, where when you are going to write your OpenGL functions for parallel projection, we used to write GL ortho, open the bracket, left, right, bottom, top, and near and far. With respect to your perspective projection, we write the representation in OpenGL, GL frustum, open the bracket, left, right, top, bottom, near, far. Okay, so in rectangular frustum view volume, and for when you are saying about the clipping plane, for clipping plane and near clipping plane, and your view plane, and with respect to this, when you are going to take about the clipping window, which will consider the six different values: left, right, bottom, top, near, far. Okay, so this with respect to XY plane, when you are going to view from Z, your projection, a reference point which is behind this particular viewing plane, and based on that you are going to take any object which is present over there. You are going to consider the value of clipping window with Z 6. Okay, and how you are going to view from given your projection reference point, the theta value, how we are going to calculate field of view. A normalized perspective projection is obtained by multiplying with standard scaling matrix, where here you are going to do normalized perspective projection is equal to, because here you are going to view from Z, and you will consider XY scale, multiply with your oblique perspective. Okay, and where 2 points says about a two oblique perspective. Okay, so Z near, and with respect to scale X, similarly with respect to scale Y, and you will consider this scaling factor to write your normalized perspective projection transformation matrix. Okay, similarly you will consider for far also. Okay, and when you write the homogeneous coordinates or obtain the new homogeneous coordinate, okay, where we consider the parameter h, and where you will write m normalized perspective with respect to given point x and y and z, when you are putting to your transformation matrix your projection coordinates, you can write with respect to x point and y point and z point. Okay, and where with respect to x point is x h divided by h, where you can see with respect to x minus z near sx of given x point plus sx of your window coordinate value, where you are going to scale the window with respect to x, okay, and similarly for y, okay, and we would like the normalization transform result between your x window minimum, y window minimum, and z near to the maximum value, x window maximum, y window maximum, and z for. Okay, when you substitute the equation which yields to get your scale of x, scale of y, scale of z, and the translation values. Okay, and similarly, when you are going to view in 3D viewport transformations, the given the normalized view volume cube extending from the minimal to maximum value is mapped to your screen viewport, which will extend from your viewport minimum, y viewport minimum, to x viewport maximum and y viewport maximum into z, the where your export view x viewport minimum value, y viewport minimum value, to x viewport maximum, to y viewport maximum value, where your z information is stored for depth calculations. Okay, and when you are often when you are going to use the linear normalized to the range from 0 to 1. Detail, we will discuss about this 3D viewport transformation in the next class. So this is about your perspective projection. Setting of perspective projection: first, your perspective projection point where the viewer, either it is a parallel or angular or your sky view, okay, camera, and comma I is positioned in the wall. Next, positioning viewing plane with respect to viewing coordinates, which results the vanishing point, either 1 or 2 or 3, okay, where 1 parallel, 2 angular, and 3 the sky view. Okay, the clipping window on viewing plane defines infinite pyramid view volume. Okay, so with respect to your z value, when you are going to consider the depth value is near or far clipping planes, it should be parallel to the view plane, defines the rectangular frustum view volume, considering your left, right, bottom, top, as well as near and far. Okay, scale and translation parameter of perspective matrix. Why we are doing scale and translation parameters of perspective matrix, which will define the normalization range.